have been Mercedesing. At the very beginning, I would like to greet someone from France that gets all the credits for this video. So, my dear girls, send a big warm kiss to Greg. Let's greet him. Greg is also someone that follows all my videos the very moment I upload them. So, again, a huge thanks for that, Greg. And you know, you really made my day today as you sent me that video in which you're showing me how the Mercedes works, how it idles. This video is going to be different comparing to my usual videos. In my usual videos, I talk to you about this or about that, about Ke Jetronic, how this part functions, what it consists of, blah, blah, blah. No. In this video, I'm going to show you how it looks like when people that ask me for advice, how they solve their issues. So, now let's talk about it in a bit more details. So, let's start. In this video, we're going to be talking about the Mercedes R107 500 SL from 86. Now I want to show you how it looks like when the owner or a mechanic listens to my advice and how his car will be repaired. This is the one of them that listened to my advice and he repaired his car. At the beginning, the car wouldn't even start. Let's look at that. Afterwards, all the rubber hoses were replaced, the pressure gauge was there, all the pressures were measured, he got the ideal difference in pressures, everything was okay, but the car wouldn't start. We've been guessing it was about this or that, or I couldn't even imagine that it would be the CO screw. He, by chance, he wanted to check it. And he told me that the previous mechanic, in order to decrease the RPM at idle, he was messing up with the CO screw. Once the owner set the CO screw, he moved it a bit clockwise, he managed to start the car. But then again, the same problem. The car was idling at 2000 RPM. Let's see how it looks like.
Then the owner had some problems with the cold start injector that wasn't powered. We've been talking about that, and he managed to solve that issue. As he showed me that video with the car idling at 2000 RPM, as he managed to get the RPM to 750, then I saw that his problem wasn't the ICV itself. I thought it wasn't clean, but he told me that he cleaned the ICV. Then I told him, well, then it's obvious that you have some problems with the ground. It wasn't the ground, but he managed to solve that issue. It was the ECU relay that was cut. The ECU relay fusible was cut. That's how he told me. At the end, he managed to solve the issue with the car. So let's look at it, how the car starts right now. And let's listen to the car. There, his problem was solved. He wrote me the message, thanks for your support. You can now even see how the car behaves on the road. And I was enormously glad that I was part of the whole project, and that I, so to speak, somehow had the contribution in this whole story for the car to run so well as it runs on the video. So, my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.